All right, so now the second question you should ask a man before you marry him is, what is his vision of success? And so essentially, how far is he trying to go? Here's what I'm saying. You know, there's a quote, I'm always saying it, where men marry women hoping they will never change. Women marry men hoping they will change. And essentially, a lot of times, women marry a man based off of untapped potential, what they still believe he can become, and not necessarily who he actually is right now. They're still hoping for better, all right? And they're optimistic about it, but still, it's a hope that may or may not be realized. And so when we talk about success, what I'm speaking more specifically to is, for example, let's just say this man, and this, there's nothing wrong with either side of this coin, but you have to understand it. Let's just say this man is, his vision of success is making $50,000, having his home, bills paid, some money saved, living a very simple life. All right. To him, he's good there. As a woman, if you can accept that and accept it with the understanding of he's not trying to go past that point, because if that's his view of success, then to him, I don't need to work harder than that. Once I get here, I'm good. If you're good with that, cool. But if you know you're a woman who's going to want him to be more than that, I would advise not moving forward. Because what happens in so many situations is, again, the woman is holding on to what she believes he can become, not understanding what he is comfortable being. And now it creates this dynamic where you're trying to pull him to this higher level and he feels a frustration and resentment towards you because you're not accepting who he is. And then you get tired with the burden of having to carry him and the frustration of the resistance he shows you, all right? This is not a situation you want to find yourself in. So it's important to find out from him what he sees as success. What is his level of content in the relationship? And ask yourself, will you be happy if he doesn't go past that? All right. Now, listen, as I said earlier, sometimes things can change. He may find a new motivation in life that makes him want to push further than that. All right. And cool, I think in most cases, a woman's not going to have a problem with a guy wanting to go higher, even if she's okay with where he's at and that never changes. But that's what you want to go in with, is like, okay, if it doesn't change, I can accept that. If it does get better, oh, then that's just icing on the cake. So make sure you have that discussion. And I also think, this is what's coming to me now, I wasn't going to mention this, but if you do view him as an unfinished product, all right. And that might be hard to acknowledge for some people. But if you view him in that way, I think it's important to have an honest discussion and say, listen, I love you. I care about you. I want to be with you. But this is where I see you. And this is where I want to see you. And then see if he says, OK, well, you know what? I wasn't thinking about going that far in life, but I can do that. And I'm cool with that. And I'm happy with pushing that far, you know. Or he might be like, nah, that's not for me. I can't see myself doing those things. I can't see myself. What you see in me, I don't accept that. All right. I don't embrace that as my life's path. And so that's when you may have to accept that, nah, you two are just not best for each other.
Hey, thank you for watching this video. Be sure to check this one out right here. And I'll see you there.
Marriage is a magnifier. It's either going to magnify the good or is going to magnify the misery. But it itself will not correct the issues that already exist in a relationship. And boy, are there some issues people